Hi everyone, in this video I will explain how I have created a terrain generator that is, it looks like this, really cool, and is created in Unity, and I will show you everything that we can customize and also internally how is developed. So as you can see, we have two terrains. This is the old version, okay, of the terrain generator, and this is the new version. Also, you can see here this image of noise, that is the generated noise of the current terrain that you are seeing here. Okay, you can see also that the terrain has automatic textures, okay, and also it has normal maps, and if you go to the sand, you can see that it has height maps. Okay, also we have a custom water that I have created, and also we can change the colors and everything. So I will show you that now. Okay, so as you can see, here we have only one piece of terrain, okay, that is the water piece and the terrain piece. But in the new modern version, we have chunks. That is an optimized version to create meshes, because if we have too much vertices in a mesh, for shader computation is really expensive. So that is why I have created chunks for the terrain and also the water. Okay, this is generated automatically in the editor, so you can see here the water chunks and the terrain chunks. Okay, so I will show you first how we can create the height map, that is this texture. Here you can see that we have some settings, okay, that we can customize in real time. We can change the size X and the size Z. We can change, for example, the persistence of the map. Okay, you can see here how it's changing everything and the texture. I will put it as it was before. We can change the lacunarity. The persistence will make more detail on the surface, and the lacunarity more things. Okay, as you can see, we have more mountains and more of everything. Also, we can change the octaves because we are not using one map, noise map, that is using Perlin noise. We are using 8 maps in this case, so we can put more or less. Also, we can change the scale. Okay, we can make bigger or smaller the changes. For example, I put here 0.5. 1.5. Okay, as you can see this, because we have a lot of different things. Okay, perfect. So that is the basic of the noise, as you can see. Also, you can see that this has a shape of an island, okay, and this is done with the create island. If I uncheck this, this won't create a normal gradient that will measure the distance from the center to every pixel, and will create a new texture that will be a gradient, white in the center and black in the edges. And this can be customized with this function, okay, that you can see here. Okay, you can see how is this created, and we can also change the power. So if I decrease it, it will try to make less changes on the edges, and if I increase it, the edges will be almost water. Okay, so that is the first thing, and now I will show you how the terrain is generated. we have number of chunks, okay? So depending on this, the chunks will be smaller or bigger. Okay, so we have the width and the depth. Also, we have the height, the max height. You can see the height, okay? And also we have the height curve. So for example, if I put this, it will have more water. And if I put this, it will have more terrain, okay? So we can also customize this height curve. Then we have the terrain material and the gradient. I will show you first the gradient, okay? So I will hook here and I will put in this shader, apply vertex color, okay? So main terrain, and here we can change the gradient depending on the height, okay? I have created this, but for example, you can put that you don't want green for the grass and you want red. So it will create red for the grass, okay? So that is the gradient. And then for the water, we can put the height of the water, and this will put the water in different height. And also we need to specify the terrain material and the water prefab. So I will start with the terrain material, that is this, and I will explain these things, okay? Because this is for an effect, that is a selected effect that is for a player, okay? So it's not important and relevant for our tutorial. So here you can see that we have different textures, okay, and the height of the texture. So for example, the sand is at height 8, the mountain at height 18, and this will lerp between different heights, the textures. So for example, if I want more sand, increase the height, and as you can see, it is creating more sand, you are seeing there. To show it better, I will disable the apply vertex color, and I will put the same. So now you can see that we have more sand, okay? The sand is only in the water, in this case. So I will show you the shaders, okay? And here, for the terrain, that is this, we have four different things. The first is the height shader, that is for changing the height of a texture with a height map that has the same structure as the connected textures, that is a lerp between different textures, okay? And then we have the selected effect I said that is not part from the tutorial because it is for the player selection in the terrain, okay? And then here we have a thing to decrease or increase the color of the terrain. Okay. So now I will start with the connected textures, that is this. We have two things that have the same structure. This is for the normal maps, and this is for the texture maps, okay, for the terrain. So you can see that we have four different textures that are the sand, the grass, the mountain, and the snow, okay? And the thing is that we lerp between the height that are the variables of the height of different environments, and we lerp between these values and the position of the height, okay? And we have a value between 0 and 1. This value will be then lerp, okay? And will be interpolated between both textures that you can see. Here we have the snow and the mountain, and we will lerp between these textures. And here we have, this will be do for between every textures, okay? We have the same. And then we will do some conditionals, okay, that are calculated here depending on the height, and we check here, for example, if the height is greater than the snow height, And we, depending on this value, we show one texture or another. If it's greater than the max height, that is the snow in this case, it will display the height, okay? If it's between the mountain and the snow, it will return the LERP that we can have calculated. And this will be done for every texture. And then we'll multiply the vertex color if we want to apply this, okay, with this boolean, and we will assign this to the base, the texture color that will be assigned in the texture of the shader as the texture color, the base color, okay, that is the albedo. And the normal maps is the same, but we put it in the normal vector of the shader that I will show you. Here we have the normal and the texture color, and we put it in the normal and the base color. Okay, so that's all. And for the height is the same structure. Okay, you can see it here. It's the same structure. I have only one height map, that is the sand. And one thing that changed is that we want to tile an offset depending on the position of the chunk, okay, to create fluent shaders. And then for the water, we have three main things. The water gradient, that we create a gradient between the surface, the terrain, that is light water blue, and the deep water color, that is in the center of the water. And this is calculated with the sim buffer to calculate the depth of the water. And also we have a normal map movement. We have two normal maps, and we create a movement in different directions of both normal maps that are here. Okay. And finally, we have the vertex displacement, that is to create waves. Depending on the time, we have a noise, a grinding noise, and we move it with the time. Okay, you can see here that this movement moving. And we assign this to the new vertex position. Okay, so that is the shader part of the terrain. Now, I will show you one more thing that is here. The water chunks are calculated as the terrain, okay? They have the same size as the chunk size of the terrain. And then I will show some scripts, okay? And we have three main scripts, because for the water is the same. We have also the camera follow, but for this tutorial, three main scripts. The height map, here are the variables that I have set. And for the height map, we go through the mass, size X, and my size set. And we calculate the Y with the Perlin noise function, okay? The X and the Z will be scaled with the noise scale, and with the lacunarity and persistence, we'll calculate the amplitude and frequency of the Perlin noise, okay? The thing is that Perlin noise don't guarantee that the value is between 0 and 1, as you can see here in the message. So it's important to get the max Y and the min Y that the Perlin noise is calculating. And here we will do an inverse LERP to create the values between 0 and 1. Okay. If it's island, we have also another array, because here is the height map array, but for the island we have the gradient, so we have another array. And we calculated the distance from the center as this. I don't use the Euclidean distance because it's more expensive computationally, so I use this simple way to calculate the distance. And then here we change the main texture with the texture that we have calculated to create it in here, this image. Okay, and that is for the height map. The terrain generator is in charge of creating the the train. So as you have seen here, here we calculated the chunk size with the chunk width count and depth count. And here we remove the previous terrain created. Okay, if we have other terrain and we want to update it, we remove everything and we create it here another time. Okay, with the new values and parameters. Here we create the chunk of the terrain and here the water terrain. Okay, so that is for the terrain generator. And here, as you can see, we need to create the chunk for the terrain. So to create this, we create a mesh, okay, with different vertices, and here with the mesh, I don't see, this is, I think, the old version. Yes, it's the old version. So the map chunk is this, sorry. Yes, it's this. So we create the chunk, okay? We add the components, the mesh filter, the mesh collider, because it's a terrain. And here we create the colors, we assign the colors with the gradient, we assign the vertices, we assign the UVs, okay? And then we calculate the triangles of the mesh. So, and then we update the mesh to assign the everything that we have created and calculate the normals. So that is all for the scripting. And as you can see, we have really cool effects. We can see the water that is really cool and animated. We can see also like everything. And I will show you one demo of this. So I will start the game. This effect that you are seeing here is the effect that I said that is the selected effect. Okay, so you can see how here how is the terrain. Okay, so that's all for this tutorial, and I hope you have understand everything or almost everything, and you can try to create your own terrain generator. So see you in the next video.